Now that you know about atoms, we're going to start building up in complexity. The first thing we need to do is just consider the fact that atoms can be joined together. They can have chemical bonds that form between them, and this is how we get molecules. In the context of living things, there are four specific types of molecules that we're going to be seeing a lot of. So this section of the course, this module, is really dedicated to just understanding those four categories of molecules in more detail. All right, so if we take a molecule and if we attach it to another molecule of the same type, and imagine if we keep doing that, what we've just done is made a long chain of molecules attached together, and that's called a polymer. So in living things, the way that polymers are formed is by a particular type of reaction. It's called a dehydration reaction. Let's just take a look at this together. Alright, so the individual sort of building blocks, we're going to call those monomers. Mono means one, poly means many. So if we take a monomer, attach it to another monomer, attach it to another monomer, so on and so forth, eventually we'll end up with what's called a polymer. Okay, so dehydration reaction. Let's take a look at this setup right here. So here we have one monomer or molecule. Here we have another monomer or molecule. And what's going to happen is a covalent bond is going to form between these two monomers. And the way that that can happen is by a reaction between these are called functional groups down here. These are just some chemical groups that tend to react with each other. Okay, so on this monomer, we have an OH group, oxygen and hydrogen. On this monomer, we have a hydrogen. And what will happen is those atoms, they are going to leave, they'll split off and leave and form a water molecule. Water is H2O, two hydrogens and an oxygen. Okay, so we've just dehydrated the system. This is called, why it's called a dehydration reaction. What we're left with is that one little oxygen. And that oxygen is going to form the bridge between these two monomers. Okay, so in the end, what we have is the two monomers have been connected by a new covalent bond that involves that oxygen. So that's an example of a dehydration reaction. Polymers in general can be formed by dehydration reactions, and this is how polymers are built in living systems. The opposite type of reaction is possible too. Suppose you eat something, suppose you eat a potato. Potatoes have a lot of starch. We'll be seeing starch in just a minute. Starch is an example of a polymer. So if you eat some starch, what will happen is your digestive system will work to break down the bonds between the monomers, essentially. So if we're breaking things down, this is called a hydrolysis reaction, and it's essentially just the opposite. So we start with some things that are already connected, and what's going to happen is water will come over and attack that bond, cause it to break, and here we go. The water molecule ends up splitting. Part of it goes and attaches to this monomer, part of it goes and attaches to this monomer. So now they've been separated. So that's called hydrolysis. This name hydrolysis means using water to split something. Lysis means to split. So two opposites, dehydration reactions and hydrolysis reactions. You'll want to know like which is which one can be used to build a polymer, which one can be used to break down a polymer. Okay, so with that being said, let's talk more about the molecules that are involved in living things. It turns out in living things, most of the molecules we'll see are going to be carbon-based, and there's a reason for that. Carbon is really versatile. It can connect to a lot of different other types of elements, and so it makes a really good sort of building material. Carbon can form up to four covalent bonds with other atoms. So what you're looking at here on the right, these are just some examples of structures that can be built using carbon. And in all of them, the carbons are sort of highlighted in green. So it's easy to string a lot of carbons together in different ways. We can have different sorts of branches, and we can end up building up really large molecules this way. Large molecules are called macromolecules. Let's see here, what else? This word organic, if we're talking about organic molecules in the context of science, that has a specific definition. Organic means that we're talking about a molecule that has carbon and also hydrogen. Those two elements are both present in the same molecule. All right, so getting into sort of where we're headed for this module, okay, we've got four different types of biological molecules. I mentioned that already earlier. What we're gonna do is walk through each of these one at a time. All of these are examples of organic molecules. So they're all built using carbon and they all have hydrogen as well.